at Government College Ujeli.
Go gather, destroy their food. Later, with the camp, and that other camp, the Songo camp, you know, compensate everybody.
In its degeneration sometimes. Today our focus will be on the style of J.T. Clark, a poet and writer, and we shall also be very interested in his poem, Akbo Dancer.
Good day and welcome to People, Places and Events, and thank you gentlemen for talking to the African Center for Community and Development. Who are you?
I'm Dr. Chandra. I'm the head of program for fisheries and aquaculture with the Research Center of Fisheries and Marine Science in Libya.
And you, sir?
My name is Morfo, a fisheries technologist and a specialist in aquaculture.
And you, sir?
My name is Abby George. I am a senior researcher in charge of coastal fisheries at Irad Limit.
Maybe we should start with general questions. The first thing, what's the condition of fisheries in Cameroon?
It has been declining since the past 10 years. And the production has reduced from about 10,000 tons to 5,000 to 6,000 tons per day the last 10 years.
Do you concur with the fact that the fishery section in Cameroon is shrinking?
Yeah, the production has been dwindling over the years, as the chairman just mentioned. The statistics give, incidentally, the realities in the industrial sector, where the production has actually halved over the last couple of years.
To add, I would just say that since the fisheries is declining, and yet we had the research institute there, is doing its best by inviting me to come and step on the water recycling system, known in Nigeria, or aquaculture recycling, as it's known in America. This system authorizes us to write to some very high density. That is what in some few months will come to have here in Iraq.
So, Doctor, what are the reasons for the decline in fisheries in Cameroon?
So the major ones include pollution from industries, pollution from petroleum extraction activities. There is also overfishing, especially by the industrial fishes, with the use of inappropriate fishing gears, with artisanal fisheries. Overfishing too is practiced, but it's not high as for the industrial fisheries. And the most used inappropriate gears are chemicals and explosives. There's also the fact that the fishing boats, they come very close to the shore, they come and fish in nurseries, go to estuaries. Nurseries, I mean, those are breeding grounds for fish legs, breeding grounds for young fish. And when they come to the nurseries, that is, they destroy the entire fish stock. So we have nothing now to regenerate the already fish stock.
Thank you so much for talking to us. You are the traditional ruler of which village?
I'm the traditional ruler of Limbola village.
Limbola village? And Limbola people, what do they do? Are they fishermen or they are farmers?
They do fishing to earn their living, and at times, farming.
I learned that a lot of fishing is taking place here from the Chinese and from other people. What is the complaint here?
These fishing trailers, they come right down to where the common man can go to do fishing. You see, instead of going
into the sea
to do their fishing, they come right down. Make now the common man cannot be able to go to the sea and then get fish, and that is why we are suffering a lot.
And even when they go to the sea, they have to go too far to get fish. Am I correct?
Exactly.
Yeah, and these Chinese, do they actually catch big fish or they catch even small fish?
They catch right to the smallest one. Right to the smallest one. Which makes the common man now not to have anything.
So if you are to talk to people watching you or to development people or to people who are into policy making, what can you say are the things your village needs?
Well, first of all, I will start by saying that those in power now, they should help to see that those fishing trailers,
they can go, further
into the sea, so that they should not come down to disturb the local fishermen. And I think if this is done, the local fisher people will be happy, because now that is their main cry.
My name is Koshive.
He says his name is Koshive. Are you? And which you who sent person for here?
I've been at the fisherman for here.
He says he's a fisherman in the beach here.
Yes.
And what will be the problem that he faces for this beach?
The problem with the fisherman for here, we not get fish. We fishermen for we not get fish again because of Chinese people.
He says they don't have fish any longer here because of the infringement that comes from Chinese trawlers.
Yes.
So now you don't provide fish for your family, for your woman and for your children.
Yes, I don't provide that because the Chinese, they stick on the area all. When you want go to the fishing, you know they go meet Chinese, then when they don't shoot all the place you go. So we know they know happen to fishing.
He's saying that when they get into the sea, they meet Chinese trawlers and they have swept all the ocean. And the ocean is bare, they can no longer bring fish to the land, and so they cannot provide for their families.
See the many days at the port.
Yes. Thank
you. Got it.
Okay. So I'm eating with my brothers who are fishermen.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, and
you got right.
You chop fish, fish.
And they give me a bit of fish.
Mm-hmm.
Is this kind of life they want to continuously live here, and that is being threatened because of the encroachment on their family grounds, their natural biodiversity, which is the sea. So I thank you, plenty.
Thank
you. For talk for me. I hope say I will get the opportunity for send una boys and in the year una problems they want to get up for you.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
About 77% of the fishermen operating in the fishing sector, they are not much from the island, from Nigeria, Togo, Ghana, and Benin. And so when they come here, there's a tendency of not having any. Any concern?
Any affiliation
to present the resource.
Yeah.
Yes.
The stock of a traditional fishermen that existed many years ago have found lucrative activities like getting employment in the petroleum industry or carrying out some kind of activity like transportation personnel from here to Nigeria, Equatorial Guinea, and also what is so interesting about the coastal culture is that the best option for a coastal man is to send his children to school to study probably up to a PhD. So many of these children who were descendants of traditional fishermen after going to school they are looking low on the profession.
This institution is an upsurge of two old institutions that were formed in 1961 and 1965 respectively. From that time to this time we find ourselves now in the 21st century and 2008. Would you say this place has gone ahead or is facing a kind of diminishing return?
Well, it's obvious that, I mean, a situation like that doesn't go, you can't make a very conclusive statement. I mean, you probably have to give positive and negative points for particular aspects. As we're saying that we have a serious problem with the resource, and we know that the chairman has given a number of reasons why the dynamics of the resource has been compromised. Due to industrial activities, human activities, abusive fishing methods. We also know that the demand for fish has increased, partly due to population trends. We're probably carrying a population of about 12% in coastal areas. We also know that many people are now educated with regards to the value of fish, or aquatic foods, and human nutrition, with the incidence of the importance of fish in maintaining, reducing the risk of a cardiovascular related infection, the incidence of fish in sustaining the immune system, with the upsurge of AIDS and hepatitis, and other opportunistic infections. So we would say that in terms of the resource, we are really in a crisis. We look at our landscape, and our landscape, we see a lot of beautiful buildings, high-rise buildings, and we want to think that, some people are taking advantage of the opportunities that lie ahead, to make their lives much better.
We can't really say that there's a lot of diminishing returns. The government has been doing quite a lot to try to replenish the resource. And even with the manpower, because recently we just had some recruitments and we didn't have had enough, but we had at least one or two technicians that were sent down here.
I want to say that the industrial method of fishing, as the fishing gear and crafts, do not go into too much capturing, that is over exploitation, too much fishing as a result of the fishing gear and the crafts we have. And I want you to write here that what you see outside is just the modern way of construction. Of fish, what are you citing?
And thank you, gentlemen, for talking to the African Center for Community and Development.